Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Aspen Channel. As you know that we are covering the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering from past few months, and accordingly we are bringing the lecture number 37 for our valuable viewers. I am very thankful for your support, encouragement and positive comments that you are giving to this lecture series. So in today's course coverage, we will again go to chapter number 7, which is related to collection and analysis of red data. So far we have studied two methods in this chapter. First method was method of excess, and then we had studied integral method, and previously we had solved an example related to it. And now in today's lecture we will be solving or using another method, which is method of initial rate, to see how we can find out the different rate parameters such as reaction order or specific reaction rate constant. Talking about the method of initial rate, and why this method has to be used, and first we start with the differential method. The use of differential method to determine the reaction order and the specific reaction rate constant can be said as the clearly the winner once we talk about it, because it requires only one experiment. But the presence of other effects such as reversible reaction could make the differential method ineffective. Obviously we yet study the differential method. First, we have to understand that why this method is needed, because this method can be said as the replacement of the differential method. In this method, or in this scenario, which is the method of initial rate, to determine the different values, we have to perform the set of experiments or series of different experiments which are run at different initial concentrations, which is CA0, and initial rate of reaction minus RA0, and then we have to compute the values of rate parameters. The initial rate of reaction can be found out by differentiating the data and extrapolating to zero time. For example, in example 7.1, the rate of reaction was found to be 0.00028 mole per cubic decimeter per minute. And if we plot it, what we have to do, that minus RA0 is equal to KCA0 raised to power alpha. And then once we take natural log of it, it will become natural log of minus RA0 is equal to natural log of K plus alpha natural log of CA0. Now this equation has become y is equal to mx plus c. So y is natural log of minus RA0, x is natural log of CA0, the alpha will be obviously the slope of this line, and natural log of k will be the intercept. Now we have seen the theoretical part of it, and we will now be moving towards the example to real time solve it. So we have been given the three trials, and for each trial we have been given the concentration of A, the concentration of B, and initial rate of reaction in mole per cubic decimeter per second. And we have been asked to compute the reaction orders and the value of K. So the system is that A of A plus B of B goes to products. Obviously small a, B are the stoichiometric coefficients, and capital A and B are the chemical species. So accordingly we can write rate is equal to K CA raised to power alpha CB raised to power beta. This is another way of representing the concentration by writing this way. For the first trial, it will become rate 1 is equal to K CA1 raised to power alpha CB1 raised to power beta. And for second trial, it will be rate 2 is equal to K CA2 raised to power alpha CB2 raised to power beta. Now, if we divide these two, what we get? Rate 1 over rate 2 is equal to K CA1 raised to power alpha CB1 raised to power beta divided by K CA2 raised to power alpha CB2 raised to power beta. Now this K will cancel out with this K, one thing. And if you see that for first trial and for second trial, the concentration of B is same. So obviously these two parameters will be cancelled out. So accordingly, we get rate 1 over rate 2 is equal to CA1 raised to power alpha divided by CA2 raised to power alpha. Or we can write it as whole raised to power alpha, rate 1 over rate 2 is equal to CA1 over CA2 whole raised to power alpha. Now if we take natural log on both sides and we have to solve it for alpha, natural log of rate 1 over rate 2 is equal to alpha into natural log of CA1 over CA2, or alpha is equal to natural log of rate 1 over rate 2 divided by natural log of CA1 over CA2. Now the value of rate 1 is 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3. For rate 2 is 4 into 10 raised to power minus 3. CA1 is 0.1 and CA2 is 0.2. So accordingly we get alpha is equal to 1. So this system is first order with respect to species A. Now, in the same way, we have to calculate for species B, for which we have to go back to the data again. And now you can see if we take 1 and 3, both of these are different. Like A is different and B is different. But if you see 2 and 3, then A will be cancelled out because of same concentration, while we can solve it for B as well. So we will be taking rate 2 and rate 3, we will be dividing it, K will be cancelled out, and the concentration of K will be cancelled out in the same way where rate 1 and rate 2 were taken. So accordingly, now solving the same for beta, rate 2 over rate 3 is equal to CB2 over CB3 raised to power beta, and I have told the reason that because the concentration of A was same in 2 and 3, so accordingly we will take it for easy solution. And natural log again taking the same way, and beta is equal to natural log of rate 2 over rate 3 divided by natural log of CB2 over CB3. So the value of rate 2 is 4 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Rate 3 is 16 into 10 raised to power minus 3. For CB2 is 0.1 and CB3 is 0.2, and accordingly we get beta is equal to 2. So the system is first order with respect to species A, second order with respect to species B. What will be the overall order? Obviously it will be the third order, because once you sum 1 and 2, obviously you get 3. So this is the third order system. So we get rate is equal to KCF raised to power 1, CB raised to power 2. Now solving for K, obviously from trial 1, so K is equal to rate over CA raised to power 1, CB raised to power 2. For rate 1, the value is 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3. CA1 value is 0.1, CB value in the first trial is 0.1. So accordingly, we get the value of K as 2, and the unit of K, obviously it will be for the third order system, and corresponding unit will be used. So now you can see it's a very simple method, but obviously we need a number of experiments to find out the value, which is obviously not the case in differential method, but you can see the calculations are relatively very simple. Once we will go to differential, you will see the calculations, they are a bit complex, while here you have to simply write a rate law and then you have to divide it accordingly to get the final answers. So that is the overall summary of method of initial rate. I hope you have understood all the aspects of this lecture. If you have any query, feedback, suggestion, please provide it in the comment box and I would be happy to answer. That's it for today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.